welcome back to the channel. Thanks again for tuning in. Today, we're gonna get the old Domar out. You've seen in our last video, we finally got it running. We're gonna get a tank of gas ran through it today on this old dead red on behind me here. So I'll show you here in a minute, but it's kind of got a lean to it in a way that is not the greatest. So we're gonna take a little finesse, try to make a good boundary between the way it wants to fall and the way we're gonna try to make it fall somewhere in the happy medium there. Just so we don't gotta fight it too hard. But I'll show you the tree here and then we'll get right at it. So we got a real nice dead red elm here. The top's all dead. It died there last year, just didn't grow leaves this spring. So it might be hard to tell, but from the camera, it's gonna wanna fall just to the left of this row of cedars if we were just to let it have its way. However, I want to steer it about 45 degrees and go just to the left of that small maple tree down there. So we're going to land it right in there is where we're going to be shooting for. It's got a little bit of a lean. It's going to help with that limb there, but the majority of it's right out here on this front corner. Going to want to pull it towards these. So we're going to go ahead and do a plunge cut, get us a slot for our wedge. We're going to chase that through a bit and then work on the face cut. Try to drive it over with the wedge there. We'll see how it goes. Stick around. So we've got the lean compensated the direction we want now. So what I'm up against here is not knowing how much give this elm hinge is gonna give me. So I left it a little thicker than I probably should have, but I wanted to make sure I got the direction I needed with the wedge. So now all I'm gonna do is go in there on this back cut and just tickle a little bit and it should go right over in the direction we want it to. We'll see how it goes.
We're close, real close here. I'm gonna bump this side just a bit. That'll go just where we wanted it.
Perfect.
For me, it don't get much better than that. Just how we planned it out and tried to make us a couple little safeties in here just to keep it from either back setting on the house or also don't want it to jump off the stump back at you, so I think it went pretty good.
So we're still learning, but that went very well for us. Gonna make some really nice firewood here and just taking the hazard away from it ever back setting onto the house in a storm or something is pretty appealing. Well, let's get it bucked up into firewood and we'll get moving on. This saw, tons of power, cuts fast, but heavier than hell. All right, well, I think that's gonna wrap us up another video there. again, thanks for coming along. Hope you enjoy these projects. We got plenty more to come. Firewood season's just beginning. So, got a lot of nice firewood down. I said red elm at the beginning, but this is definitely white elm. I'm still trying to learn them with the bark on. Either way, it's going to be great firewood. All right, friends, hit that like button. Subscribe if you're not already. Make sure you ring the bell. That way you don't miss another video. All right, we'll catch y'all next time on Ohio Hilltops. Y'all take care.